Getting robbed. Lately we have seen kind of sport cars that are a little bit questionable. Mm-hmm. Is it that's why what you guys your style it looks more towards getting a knockout? I know you both in the left side in the Santa Cruz Matas undercard, you guys both scored knockouts. Is that kind of a thing you guys are going for this fight?
No,
not to leave it in the judges?
Oh yeah, the plan is not definitely not to leave it in the judges, and if the knockout comes, the knockout's coming, and but like, I'm just trying to learn to be a little bit more patient because I'm working my way up in rounds. You know, I'm going from six and then I'm going to eight. So I can't, and like my uncle and my dad told me, you can't knock everybody out in the first, second round. So you got to learn to be patient with these guys. My uncle told me that there's going to be fights where you can't knock this person out. You know, sometimes, you know, these guys are too experienced or very strong chin or whatever. So it's just about being smart and, you know, being calm and patient in the ring. I think me and my brother's style, we're just, our style comes from where we come from because we have so much hunger and my people have been hurting for so long and we never had nothing. So this is the time to make things a change for us and my family. So that's the reason why I feel like me and my brother fight like that. But I don't think we go in there looking for the knockout. It's just the way we fight or the way we are.
A lot of prospects do seem to base their, you know, kind of bringing up, their career bringing up on knockouts though. Like we saw Ryan get extremely criticized for going 12 rounds with Jason Velez, even though Jason Velez went, 10 rounds with Jojo Diaz as well. So how would you guys take that, the criticism, if you don't, like you said, knock out the guy in the first two rounds, like most prospects now tend to try to do?
I mean, well, you gotta understand that people are gonna talk regardless. If I knock this guy out, they're gonna say, oh, he was nothing. If I didn't knock this guy out, they're gonna be like, oh, he wasn't good enough. So I don't pay attention to what they say or what they talk about. I pay attention to what we gotta do in the ring. I don't let none of that stuff try to distract me because it is distracting. You got a lot of people criticizing you left and right for, you know, for a lot of reasons. And if you let that get in your head, then it can mess with you as a fighter, you know? So I don't pay attention to that.
Yeah.